Hey, what's up, explorers? Adam Carroll, no Nick Durr here today, flying solo on another episode that is sponsored by our friends at Thrivent Student Resources. The folks at Thrivent Student Resources have compiled an amazing amount of content for you, and I'm here to share some of that with you. Today, we're talking about the six things you need to consider when searching for the right college. So this seems to be one of the biggest points of contention for young people, 17, 18 year olds, as well as their parents, who are trying to navigate this decision of where to go and what to study and all of that. And I want to let some of the students out there off the hook. This is a big decision, no doubt. But I want you to know that you will make it okay. No matter where you go, no matter what you study, you will be fine. And in this video, we're going to talk about the six things you can consider when choosing the right college, and that means the right college for you. All right, so in these six things, we're going to start with number six, and we're going to go backwards to number one. Number six, the sixth thing that you should consider when choosing a school is the feel of the university. And when I say feel, like, what does it feel like when you're on campus? What does it feel like to walk around, to experience the campus environment, to meet people, etc.? What is the feel of that campus? And you'll know it based on your campus visits, which should happen sometime in your junior or senior year. Those campus visits are a really important trip to take because you do get a true sense of the feel of what it's like to be on either a small campus or a large campus, a campus where there are massive lecture halls and those where the class sizes are only 30 students. So keep in mind, what does it feel like when you're on campus? Can you feel yourself succeeding in that environment? Number five in the things to consider is the placement rate of that university. If you choose to pursue a certain major, one of the questions that you're going to want to ask is, how many of those graduates from that particular major actually get a job in that major? So if it's a very high percentage, means that the placement rate is very good, that's probably a decent major to study because you know there's going to be a job on the outside. Now, if there is a low placement rate, what you want to do is you want to find out why. Are people graduating from that major and then not getting jobs? If so, that's a pretty clear indicator. That may be one you'll want to stay away from. Tip number four is graduation rate. So of the students who start school at this esteemed university, how many actually graduate? Because I didn't go to college. Well, I did go to college to have fun and to meet people and have new experiences, but I went to graduate. So I want to know how many people start at this university and end up graduating from that university. Very, very important thing to know. Number three on the consideration list is the location of said university. You want to find out, is it close to home? Is it far away from home? I know some students that want to be within an hour or less of their parents. And I know some people that want to be a world away from their parents. So you need to decide from a location perspective, what is perfect for you? Do you want to be close to home? Do you want to be farther away? Are you comfortable being a plane ride or a long bus ride away from home? And if so, that might dictate where you look as well. I also have known students who choose places like Southern California or Hawaii to look for schools because they love the environment that they're in. Now, this leads me to the next thing to consider. Number two in the considerations is affordability. So if you're looking at a place like, oh, let's say Hawaii or maybe Notre Dame, and you know that the price is really high, the cost of living is really high, and I think about places like San Francisco, right, or UC Berkeley, the cost of living in the city of Berkeley is astronomical. So from an affordability perspective, one of the things you have to look at is what are not just the tuition costs, but what are my housing costs? What are my living expenses? If I want to come home over the holidays, how much will that be? Affordability strikes at the very heart of the challenge that's going on today, and that is the student loan debt epidemic. More and more students and families today are choosing schools based on the affordability of that university and actually the value of that university than they are any of the other things to consider. And that leads me to number one. Number one in the things that you should consider in terms of choosing your college or university are the degree programs that are offered and what can you major in. So I know that for some students, they're coming in blind. They're going into college not knowing what they want to do or who they want to be. They're just kind of testing the waters, and that's perfectly fine. You will more than likely change your majors 3 or 4 times throughout your college career. I know students who have changed their major 6, 7, 8 times, and they still come out on the other side with a degree, and they're gainfully employed as baristas. I'm kidding. They're not gainfully employed at all. I'm kidding about that too. They are gainfully employed in whatever career field they chose. Just because you don't know your major or you don't know where you want to go does not mean that you're not going to be successful down the road, but it does help to understand, maybe have a high level understanding of what you'd like to study, and then choosing schools that have those particular majors available before you choose the school. So there you have it, 6 things to consider when choosing a school. We talked about degree and major offered. We talked about affordability. We talked about location and graduation rate, the placement rate, and last but not least, the feel. How does it feel to be there? There's a lot more great content on thriventstudentresources.com. Check that out, including a really important college search tool. And it teaches you exactly how to go out and find the schools that you are most interested in based on all of these factors and then some. Check that out at thriventstudentresources.com. And make sure that if you want to elevate your money mindset and get more out of your finances, that you watch one of these videos here and you subscribe to the channel, because we post new videos every Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Our goal is to have fun and to elevate your money mindset. Until next time. See you soon.